In recent times, the fight against Galamsey has come under criticisms as many people think the problem is resurfacing. Many mining communities are currently challenged with unclean water and destruction of their vegetation as a result. The Ghana Water Company Limited in both the Western and the Ashanti regions have expressed concern over the shortage of water as a result of illegal mining activities.
We also have Galamsey issue where we have a lot of silt inbuilt in the intake site. As this Galamsey activities is going on, it brings along a lot of silt and they come to deposit at our intake. So we need to take these silts out so that we can get a lot of water to be able to produce.
Okay, the major threat is that the activities, they muddy the water. And so our turbidity levels keep rising, our color levels keep rising. And because of that, you need more chemical to treat the water. If the turbidity levels are low, the color levels are low, a little chemical and then you're able to get the desired output that you want. But when the turbidity keeps going up, the color keeps going up, you need more chemical to be able to treat the water so that you can get a desired output.
To add salt to injury was the shocking news of the missing 500 excavators which were seized in line with curbing the menace. Fast forward, 6 persons were arrested by the police CID for the alleged involvement in the missing excavators issue. Amongst them is the suspended NPP Central Regional Vice Chair, Eko Ewusi. In this light, the public, especially the opposition NDC, has accused government of losing the fight against illegal mining in Ghana, but government says otherwise.
These jaw-breaking revelations, which are a testament of how corruption has assumed epidemic proportions under President Akufo-Addo, do not come to us as a surprise at all. In fact, these later developments are a vindication of our long-held position that President Akufo-Addo's so-called fight against illegal mining is a ruse calculated to appropriate the illicit Galamsey trade for MPP and government officials.
Minister for Information Kojo Opon Nkrumah says that government, in line with the law, has handed the case to the right authorities for further investigations.
It would have been disappointing if the minister had just left it at that. The minister, after mentioning that not all the excavators and other materials that were confiscated are being properly accounted for, has further written to the police, I think a series of letters, pointing out persons who he believes have something to say or something to do with the status of those assets that were confiscated, and asking that the police investigate. And my understanding is that the police have commenced an investigation, has already done some arrest or effected some arrest, and is proceeding to investigate persons associated with it. I think what we need to do is to all be interested in the police investigation, look forward to the kind of results that they bring out, so that we can be clear what exactly has transpired, and if any person is culpable, have that person dealt with in accordance with the law.
President Akufo-Addo, upon assumption of office, promised to end the illegal mining menace which the country has been grappling with for years.
For City News, my name is Kweku Adeoma Ansah.